Yeah, let's talk about Alonso. That's the biggest news.
Go for it. Begin.
Well, okay, we'll go to the next tab here. We'll look at start off with the diagram.
So what happened? Because there's a lot of people that are saying a lot of different things. And a lot of it just sounds like, I mean, it sounds like the stuff that I would say, like, to make excuses for. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, I don't know. Mercedes, they seem kind of, McLaren seem kind of
on the fence,
wishy-washy about what they want to say in the media about this. So this picture was... I don't know. It sort of explains what happened, but there's, I don't know. There's actually a video there too.
The actual photographs that we see there, those are taken by that photographer, and it's clearly that this is taken from some sort of Spanish publication or something. We took it from Reddit, just as a courtesy of Reddit, because they didn't say where this was from. But either way, so those pictures at the front, those are the only pictures of from that angle. So based on these pictures, this guy put together this simulation. So the line in red here that you see, that's the normal racing line.
Okay.
That's what you would take to approach this corner. Now, the thing is that during a normal, like if you're going around a circuit like this, you're going in that direction, you see the racing line here in red. If you're going to fuck that racing line up, then most people, like, what would happen during, like, if you fuck it up, you normally expect to see a driver go, like, down here, you know, not on the inside.
Right.
And that's the number one thing that was puzzling about this accident.
Well, here's the thing. Let's look at quickly the Pastor Maldonado link right there. We can't show it, though.
Oh, okay.
We can, well, let's watch it.
I know, I gotta switch my,
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
We're going to watch it and describe it to you because of copyright law.
Well, just say what it was.
Basically, last year, Maldonado came around the same corner and almost identically crashed into the same corner. So, yeah, let's watch this quickly. So here you see him.
He's going around. He loses control. Then it all goes really, really, really bad for him when he steps on a piece of AstroTurf.
He lost control on... turn one. But there he goes.
He hits
the fake grass and
that's it.
He goes behind the hill. But here, look, the second corner, he's losing control
already.
Can't get the grip back and goes straight to the outside and touch the AstroTurf.
See, this is AstroTurf. As soon as he's done that,
watch his hands.
Too much power.
Look at the force of that though. He's using two hands to hold the steering wheel locked left. Almost identical to what Alonso did yesterday.
Yeah. So on the inside, as a consequence of maybe going, stepping on the AstroTurf a bit too much. Let's go back to this picture.
Seems like maybe they should pull the AstroTurf out of there, but really, like where that white line is kind of like to the bottom left of the picture there. That's basically where you're supposed to be coming out of the corner. But I don't know. There's a lot of because of the weather, the winter weather, it was crazy windy there.
Yeah, it was the windiest day.
One of McLaren's excuses that the wind blew him into the wall.
Now, here's what I think actually happened. I think it was something very similar to that Maldonado crash, but it has to do with the way that the McLaren was delivering that power. A McLaren or the Honda engine, more like it, was delivering the power. I think that Alonso was trying to take it easy around this corner because he felt the action of the wind or something happened like that, and he was trying to take it easy around this corner, and then something happened, and the power just kicked in when he was on the AstroTurf, and he lost control. Because there's no way that he would have hit there and there after being on the racing line if he hadn't lost control of the car. Like, this was, you know what I mean? Like, it just doesn't make sense that if it was something else, like, say, like, if your steering column breaks, like, if you're just can't turn and the car is, like, turning any, like, somewhere else that you want it to, what you would expect from that is for it to go and run wider,
right?
Because it would just keep going in the direction, right? But just not this. This means, like, this to me says he lost control. Now, Toby Gruner, right here.
That was one of the other conspiracy theories, was that there was some sort of a curse dump by accident, or that he got or that he got electrocuted and was unconscious when the accident happened.
Well, that's the thing. Yes, yeah. Some people are saying that.
So
maybe,
many wild theories about it.
That maybe he fainted.
He could have fainted from the G-force. Could be the wind. Could be a curse dump. Could be electrocution.
We don't know yet.
Could be a lie.
Could be the grass.
Could be a blatant lie. The thing is that we haven't heard from Alonso himself. All we've heard about, the only thing that McLaren have confirmed
is that he got into an accident.
is that he got into an accident, exactly, and that he's okay.
Okay, yeah.
He seems to be okay. They've run an MRIs, CT scan, a CT scan and MRI came back saying that he's perfectly fine.
Normal.
Yeah. But
he did smash the wallet. Absorb 30 G's.
30 G's
through his body.
Oh my God!
The first,
he did have a concussion. So
yeah, he got a concussion during the crash, though, not before the crash. So during the crash, because right. I mean, 30 G's. So that means that at one point your head becomes 30 times heavier than it is, and it just like pulls and gets banged up. 30 G's is a lot. I mean, the more that you see these cars pull around the corner, even like when they're going fast, it's like what, like 4, 5, 6 G's tops.
Yeah. Well, Gio Bianchi absorbed, it was like 49 or something like that, 48 or 49 last year.
And he's still in a coma. So 30 G's is a lot, and they said that the car actually looks surprisingly well for having absorbed 30 G's.
Yeah,
so what they're saying is that like maybe Alonso was the one that absorbed most
of it.
Yeah, most of that energy, and you gotta think about it, like even if like in pure physical terms, if he's going at that speed and he's crashing, they come into a dead stop. And the car doesn't deform, doesn't break away, and there's 30 G's there that were recorded in the sensor, and that all goes through your body. It does something to you.
Mm-hmm.
It like it fucks you up in ways.
Rattles you, man.
Yeah, man. Exactly.
Your brain is flying.
And other even saying that Alonso might not even make it to the second test of in Barcelona. So that's the test that's coming up later this week, starting Thursday, because of this.
He himself tweeted something like. His team has one of the best drivers in the wind tunnel. I think he meant in the simulator, but...
Oh.
Suggesting he might be there for testing next week. I don't know.
Pedro de la Rosa. Oh, wait. No,
Magnussen, right?
Yeah, Magnussen. That's true. Magnussen. Yeah.
He tweeted that he's been in the wind tunnel, but... Yeah. He is one of the more competitive drivers, I guess.
That is true. Yeah, he did a great job last year.
Well, the more competitive ones that work for McLaren.
I find this thing that Vettel said. I don't think it would benefit Vettel in any way or another to like lie or make this up. No. I think that this is genuine. That he was going. Oh, yeah, obviously, I mean, he says his speed was slow.
Yeah. Maybe, only 150.
Yeah, only 150 around that corner. Yeah. That's still a lot. See, he's still going fast, but he's going slow for an F1 car.
And it is probably one of the faster corners in the season too.
Yeah, we wait to see.
We'll find out.
We'll wait to see what happened to Alonso. Really,
check out that next tweet, because the night of the accident, these pictures came up.
Oh,
show the skid mark that he left.
So he was trying to break.
Yeah, but it's kind of weird. Only it looks like only the inside tire was breaking.
Oh yeah, that's only.
You
know,
you can sort of see like on the right picture, especially it's a bit lighter. You can see like maybe a scrape mark. You can see where the tire bumped over the inside curb. See the top side.
Oh, yeah, this one.
Yeah, that's the other tire.
Ah.
But leading up to it, only the inside tire was locked. So.
Yeah. Only that one tire.
And turning, I think turning left, probably your outside tire should be heavier, right? So, I don't know. It's kind of weird. Maybe like that locked tire would pull you into the wall.
We don't know what happened here. It's all very mysterious.
Yeah.
Move over to that next video, because
you know
I think
what?
This
I
is
love,
the best.
I love mystery. That is. Can we show this?
Yeah.
Flash has crashed.
That's fine.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah, this
I think
is somebody.
This is the best maybe explanation I think of what happened. Somebody in the audience here recorded this. You can see him going fast as hell around the first two corners.
Yeah, so it's not like he's going super fast.
Disappears to the top of the hill. Somebody took over with a video game here.
This is great.
So probably giving up his flying lap, Alonso starts to decelerate around to 150 kilometers an hour.
So questions have to be asked.
touches the grass. According to McLaren, Alonso picked up the extra turf on turn three exit, and that's where his problems began. Oversteered, slid into the wall. Car's pointing forwards toward the barrier with a big angle, but then McLaren straightens just before crashing into the wall while he's on the grass. And the impact is nearly sideways on the bare wall. And the suspension remains intact, even though bent. So a great part of the energy is dissipated directly through Alonso's body. A 30G impact is a lot. And then he bounced multiple times on the wall before stopping. And a second 15G impact is recorded before the car fully stopped.
Toby of AMUS, he's also said that this is the one that actually like fucked him up most, because it was a sustained 15G. It wasn't a
instantaneous.
No, it was a sustained. We're talking about milliseconds, like 54 milliseconds, but still, that's the one that does the damage. Yeah. I'm glad people have taken the time to do this.
This is amazing.
Yeah.
This is blowing my mind.
Yeah, somebody broke it down.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
Thank you.
Ooh, look at all these angles.
Yeah.
Seems pretty accurate. You still can't tell what happened to the car.
Yeah.
I think only Honda knows for sure.
Honda and McLaren are gonna have to like release.
They're gonna need to make a statement.
Yeah, this because it.
Well, I guess they're waiting for Alonso. He must be home by now this afternoon.
Man, they said
the thing is, what's his buddy's name here? Said Alonso doesn't remember even what happened. I forget the dude's name.
That was Briatore, wasn't it?
Yeah, Briatore. But yeah, I guess he must have spoken to Alonso.
Well, okay, YouTube's autoplays.
Oh, yeah. Uncheck that box in the top right.
This one?
Bullshit. Yeah, they added that like a week ago.
Bastards.
Feed you more advertising. Briatore, I guess Alonso's buddy. Who is this dude?
Well, okay, Briatore, Flavio Briatore was the team boss for the old Renault team back when Alonso won his titles in 2005, 2006. And further than that, he became, in a way, Alonso's manager. But yeah, they have been friends since then. Now, Briatore got kicked out of F1 and told never to come back because when he was a team principal at this Renault team, he basically told Alonso's teammate to crash purple, and this was like on the like everybody could hear it.
Oh my
God. He was like, you're gonna turn, and after this turn you're gonna crash, so that Alonso could win.
the famous crash gate.
Yeah,
Jesus crash Christ.
Gate. And as a consequence of that, this dude, this Briatore guy, was told not to ever come back to Formula One ever again.
Jesus, I wonder why.
He must have visited Alonso in hospital. Well, can you throw up the link I just sent you?
They're actually good friends. Or, you know, from what we understand, they are actually friends. This Briatore guy. But that's all we know.
From back in that day, here's a photo. Alyssa Alonso's second really serious accident in his career. This is not from the other day. This is, he's wearing his Renault uniform. That was the last time he was taken away in a stretcher.
Damn.
We don't even have pictures of that because...
they had a blanket.
They had like some sort of a blanket covering it. They just didn't want people to see the way he was.
That's heavy.
And also because the testing is in Barcelona and Alonso is Spanish. Okay. So they didn't even release in the beginning. The first day they didn't release the name of the hospital he was in because they were afraid that too many fans were going to flock it. Not let the poor guy rest. But for what we understand and what we've seen on social media and whatever else, he's like posted pictures of like, you know, with thumbs up.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently the CT scan and MRI are good. So he's joking
about his teammate taking over for him. It's very
somehow sudden. He's in good condition, but he might, we'll see, because he might not be there at the end of this week when the second testing starts to happen.